Section 6 of the chapter 3, lattice vibration, is about dispersion relation of lattice vibration. Let us consider one-dimensionally aligned crystal. The crystal composed of only one kind of atom, and the atomic mass is m, and lattice spacing is a. The atoms are bonded by springs with a force constant c. Let us consider the atom number s. So this is the atom number s, and the position of the this atom from the original point is s times a, and left neighboring atom is number s minus 1, and the position of this atom with respect to the original point is s minus 1 times a. The right neighboring atom is the number s plus 1, and the position of this atom with respect to the original point is s plus 1 times a. Then we consider the net force on the atom of interest when the atoms are displaced. The forces are caused by the interaction with the neighboring atoms s minus 1 and s plus 1. So the displacement of the atom number s is u sub s, and the displacement of atom s minus 1 is u sub s minus 1, and atom s plus 1 is u sub s plus 1. The force from the neighboring atom is proportional to the difference of the displacement. If the, for example, s minus 1 and s displaced in the same degree, then this spring does not shrink or does not extend. Therefore, no force occurs between these two atoms. So the force from the left spring F minus is the spring constant C times U S minus 1 minus U S. Force by the right spring is F plus is equal to C times U S plus 1 minus U S. The net force to the atom of interest, S atom, is F plus plus F F minus plus F plus, which is equal to C times U sub S plus 1 minus 2 times U sub S plus U sub S minus 1, equation 3.6.3. Then let us consider the equation of the motion of the S atom. The mass of the atom times the second derivative of the displacement of the atom S is equal to the force is equal to C times U sub S minus 1 minus 2 times U sub S plus U sub S plus 1. Because the atomic vibration in the periodic lattice can be considered as an ensemble of waves, the solution of the this equation should be in the form of a wave function. Therefore, we assume the US can be expressed as A times the amplitude times exponential function plus minus IKX times exponential function of I omega T is equal to A times exponential function plus minus iksa times exponential function I omega t, equation 3.6.5. The reason of the this iksa is iksa the distance from the original point and or the position of the oscillation. We substitute equation 3.6.5 into equation 3.6.4, the equation of the motion, we have m times second derivative of with respect to time times with respect to time of a times exponential function plus minus I k s a times exponential function I omega t is equal to c times a exponential function plus minus I k s minus 1 a exponential function I omega t because this is u s minus 1 minus 2a exponential function of plus minus I k s a times exponential function I omega t plus a times exponential function of plus minus I k s plus 1 a s exponential function I omega t because this is u s plus 1. Please note that plus minus of the wave vector indicates the direction of the propagation. Then we simplify equation 3.6.6, m equal second derivative over time with respect to this one, time is equal to the force constant times sum of each displacement. Then the second derivative of exponential function of I omega t becomes minus omega squared, then minus m omega squared a times exponential function plus minus I k s a exponential function I omega t is equal to c times this. So here this part is the exponential function plus minus I k s minus 1 minus a exponential function I omega t, and exponential function plus minus I k s minus 1 can be divided into the product of exponential function plus minus I k s a exponential function minus I k a and exponential function plus minus I k s plus 1 a can be divided into the product of exponential function plus minus I k s a times exponential function I k s a. The amplitude a appears all terms, therefore they are it is cancelled, and the exponential function of plus minus omega k s a also appear all terms, and exponential function of I omega t also appear. Therefore, the equation of the motion are simplified as minus m omega squared is equal to c times exponential function of minus ika plus exponential function plus ika minus 2. And exponential function minus ika times exponential function plus ika can be written in this way, and minus I sine ka cancels, then it becomes 2 cosine ka. Therefore, omega squared is equal to minus c over m times 2 times cosine ka minus 2. Then it is equal to 2c over m times 1 minus cosine ka. Then cosine ka can be written as 1 minus sine ka over 2 squared. Therefore, it becomes 4 times c over m times sine ka over 2 squared. Therefore, dispersion relation is obtained as omega equal square root of 4c over m times sine ka over 2, equation 3.6.7. Because this is sine function, it goes to unity at when ka over 2 equal pi over 2, and With a large K, the higher omega, therefore, the velocity changes. But there is no proportionality between K and omega, especially at high K and high omega. This diagram shows the dispersion relation omega equal 4c over m k omega sine ka over 2. So this is 0 point and this is pi over a. Then horizontal axis is wave number k and vertical axis is omega normalized by 4c over m square over square root of 4c over m. So the group velocity of the lattice wave is vg is equal the derivative of the angular frequency omega with respect to the angular wave number k. So this slope, therefore, at low wave number or low omega wave frequency, or long period or long wavelength, the velocity is high, but it decreases with increasing wave number or frequency. Then it becomes zero at pi over k equal pi over a. So at low wave number or low frequency, the relation is nearly linear. Therefore, group velocity is nearly equal to phase velocity Vp because the derivative of omega with respect to wave number k is nearly equal to the ratio of the omega to k. In contrast, again, at very high omega or high k, the wave group velocity is very low, and at pi omega over a, group velocity is zero. Equation 3.6.8. So, what situation is this? Is a question. Let us remember we are considering a one-dimensional crystal, which is a collection of atoms. The crystal has a limited size, therefore, the number of atoms are limited. Let us consider the number of atoms is n, then the length of the size of the crystal is L equal n minus 1 times A. So this is the longest wavelength for this crystal. Lambda max is equal to L. So this is such a situation. This is a whole length of crystal and there is only one wave in this crystal and whose wavelength is nA minus 1 or nearly equal nA. Then the smallest wave number is km minimum is equal to 2 pi over L plus minus 2 pi over L 3.6.9. Then on the other hand, the distribution of the atom is discrete, therefore there is a almost fixed atomic spacing A. Therefore the shortest wavelength lambda minimum is equal to 2A. So this illustration shows such situation. every two crystals oscillate in the same direction, and the other every two atoms oscillate in the same direction, and the other atoms oscillate in the opposite direction. And wavelength is between this atom and this atom, which is 2a. Therefore, the largest wave number, k max, the absolute value of k max is equal to 2pi over 2a, which is equal to pi over a, equation 3.6.10. In this case, the atom oscillates vertically, therefore group velocity is zero. The wave is standing. The range of the wave number from minus pi over a to plus pi over a, at this point the group velocities are zero, is referred to as the first Brillouin zone. Then question is, what is the wave out of the first Brillouin zone? Let us consider the wave with this wave number k. This wave is identical to the wave with a wave number k prime, which is k minus 2 pi over a. Let me explain this situation by the this diagram. Green balls are the atoms, and short wave is wave with a wave number k, and long wave is wave with a wave number k prime. You can see the both of the long wave and short wave go through these atoms. Therefore, for the atoms, these two waves are identical. Let me explain this issue by mathematics. So the wave number k is out of the first Brillouin zone, and the identical wave within the first Brillouin zone is k prime. The difference is 2 pi n over a. N is integer. So k prime is equal to k minus 2 pi n over a. Then let us consider the wave a exponential function of I times exponential function of I ksa times exponential function of I omega t, which is equal to a times exponential function of I k prime plus 2 pi n over a sa times exponential function of I omega t. Then this exponential function can be separated as a times exponential function of I k prime sa times exponential function of I 2 pi n s times exponential function of I omega t. Because n and s are integer, therefore exponential function of I 2 pi n s is equal to unity. Therefore, this wave a exponential function of I k s a exponential function of I omega t is identical to a exponential function of I k prime sa exponential function I omega t. So this is the end of the section 6, dispersion relation of lattice vibration, chapter 3 of lattice vibration.